is focus on Google Form. Let's take a look at what Google Form is all about before we look at why are we focusing attention on Google Form in comparison with other tools that are available there. Google Form is a tool that allows the collection of information from users through a personalized survey. The information is collected, automatically connected to a spreadsheet. I would say I've decided to narrow what Google Form is in with respect to the context of our presentation. I would say Google Form is such a robust tool that can be used for virtually anything that has to do with getting information, so long we can work within the robustness, flexibility it offers. One good thing is that you can use it as a means of testing. You can test and it has auto grade features, but that is not the concern for today. It's concerning more on solving. Now, why the focus on Google Form? Well, unlike most other, well, to the best of my knowledge, maybe the information might not be completely right. I think Google Form is the only web-based form that is available with a free mode and gives you unlimited survey. It doesn't limit the number of participants that you can collect information from. And of course, survey answers and data are automatically collected in Google spreadsheets. Another thing is that it has lots of team options. It has customizable logo that you can adjust to your own taste. It has possibility to add images and videos. It has one beautiful thing which you also use as part of the demo, say as part of the demonstration, skip logic and page branching. What this is that there might be some set of information in your questionnaire that not everybody should fill. Let me give a typical example of a project on adolescent reproductive health. In the form, the information boys are to fill are different from the information girls are to fill. So the first question is to indicate your gender, male, female. If it were to be paper questionnaire, we say if you are male, go to page 3. If you are female, go to page 4. With this skip logic and page branching, automatically Google Form will take you to the appropriate section. Are you a male or female? You tell us you're a male. Automatically, based on your response, you are taken to what next you are expected to fill. That's another beautiful thing that Google Form has. Some other web-based tools have it as well. Options to embed survey into emails or website. This is another beautiful thing. As it were, some of us might have seen the form we use as an example in our email. You, without having to click on any link, you see the survey directly in your email. As you open it, you can fill it directly. It's as if it's integral part of your email. We can also embed it in a website. That immediately you get to the website, you click on a link, you on a tab, you just open up and you fill the questionnaire. That's another beauty of it. Then possibility to add collaborators. This is one other wonderful thing. 2, 3 or multiple researchers can be together and work on the same questionnaire without having to be together physically. And one other beautiful thing that I love to personally use in advocating for the use of Google Form is that it is 100% free. Free as in free. All the features are available free. And this gives that robustness that we need as researchers on lean budget. You know that when it has to do with collecting your data using Google Form, you don't have to pay a single dime for using the service. And so let us take a look at how we can then create our online survey using Google Form. I want to assume that we are starting afresh, that we don't have a Google account. So the first thing is you have to create a Google account. One good thing is that Google now links up all its products with your single account. If you have a Gmail account, then you already have a Google account, then you already have the wide array of what Google calls is Google Suite, comprising of several products, in which Google Form is just one of such several products available. So the first step is, if you do not have a Google account, have a Google account, or simply just create a Gmail account. And another thing is, just assuming you are starting afresh, on your browser, type drive.google.com. We're going to take a look at this in our hands-on experience later. And of course, on your Google Drive, you can click New. We're going to see it, as I said. In the New, something of this nature, you can see it. You have the drive, you see the New, which has been highlighted. And when you click on that, you're going to see pop-up options. One of them is Google Form. When you click on that Google Form, you're going to see two options: a blank form or from a template. We are assuming you are starting from scratch. You have the options of choosing from a template, in which you have pre-designed templates you can just use and adjust. You can also decide to start afresh with a blank form, which is the option we are going through. So if you choose that option, you may see something like this. It gives you something like this on title form and something of this nature. So what are those things that are expected? We're going to expose ourselves to them briefly. In the untitled form, what you're expected to do is to type the title of your form, whatever you think the title is. And in this case, we just said we are using participant information. So that automatically captures. One good thing I also want to mention is that you don't need to save anything. Since it is online-based, all your work you do are automatically saved. Now, so we say this again just to give us an indication of what each of those sections stand for. We see the form description. We see the untitled question, that is to type your questionnaire item there. Then the other place where you see multiple choice, there's a drop-down menu there that gives you the various item options that are possible, which we're going to mention briefly, but in the hands-on experience, we'll be able to see that. Now, what are some of the options? Google continues to update its products. As at when I'm talking, I don't know what will happen from tomorrow, there are 11 possible options that are there that Google creates in terms of options. We'll look at them now. Let's look at the item types, 11. We will not be able to go through the 11 in detail, but we'll attempt to mention them. We have short answer. In this case, you just want to collect brief information and the participant has to write or type by themselves. For example, what is your name? What is the email? What is the name of your institution? The participant have to do so, a little bit of typing. Paragraph. In this case, it is the same thing, but it allows for extensive writing. Maybe describe what you did yesterday. That will involve much of writing. So you click on that item option, paragraph. Multiple choice, just as some of us in test development are conversant with, it is where you have an item with various options. Google Form allows you to have as many options as it's possible. Maybe which of these best describe your institution. Then, out of the options, you have to pick just only one: public higher educational institution, private higher educational institution, and what have you. You have them as the options. That is multiple choice. But in the case of multiple choice, you can only pick one out of the various options. Related to that is check boxes. Sometimes you are allowed to pick more than one options. We may have a situation whereby you ask, which of these best describe your situation? You are a student, you are a worker, you are a postgraduate student, you are a lecturer. So I cannot restrict you to just pick one of the options. So you are a student, you click, you check the box. You are a lecturer, you check the box. You are a mother, you check the box. And so that is what makes checkbox different from the multiple choice. Dropbox and multiple choice are almost the same. The only difference is that in the case of multiple choice, the options are seen at once. In the case of Dropbox, you have to click before you see the options. File upload. This may require, it allows you to upload the file, perhaps whatever, maybe they contain some documents you want the respondent to read before they respond, whatever the nature of it. Linear scale is for the respondent to respond on a scale that you have decided. To what extent do you think that this thing is good or bad on a scale of 5, where 1 represents very poor, 5 represents very good? What do you think is the level of achievement of Mr. A on a scale of 5 or on a scale of 10? Whatever it is, that is what you do for linear scale. Multiple choice grid is a situation, in fact, most often what we do in most of our questionnaire, where you have several items with fixed number of options. I have 10 items, and each of the items I want you to respond with yes, no, not sure. Have you eaten this morning? Yes. Are you going out after you finish eating? No. Do you have money in your pocket? Not sure. Each of these items you are allowed to respond based on the 3 pre-specified options. That is multiple choice grid. Checkbox grid, just like between multiple choice and what we call it, checkboxes. In checkbox grid, we also have a lot of items with fixed options. But in this case, you can choose more than one option per item. That is the slight difference between checkbox and multiple choice grid. Date. Yes, your respondent might be required to choose a date, maybe date of birth. You want them to choose anything. When, which year did you gain admission to the university, to just go and pick a date. Time, the same thing, you might want them, the respondent, to choose a particular time. So these are the possible 11 item options that are available. We try to demonstrate quite a number of them, but not all. Now, when you look at the menu by the right-hand side, you're going to see things that you need. You know, when you create your form, you have a blank form, you put in the information, then you can give the description. Then when you now look, you see something like plus, that is to add questions. So when you click on that, it adds a question. This is a recent development, import questions. You might have got questions in previous Google Forms. You can easily go and import from them rather than recreating the question. Then the next one is to add title or description. For example, I want to add a section for title, another title, and then just like I have it, I can easily do it from there. Then add image. Maybe I have an image I want to add video, add section. Under add section, that means just like I'm having it in page by page, this is a particular section, then I want to add another section so that the respondent will not just be seeing all the pieces of information on the page. That is what that is meant for. We also see some other things down below. Duplicate items, maybe the particular question, you want to duplicate it to make it easier for you, or you want to delete it entirely. And this other one is required, that little button which you are just to drag to the right, if you want to make it mandatory for your participant to fill that, to provide response to that particular question. In this case, without providing answer to that question, the participant cannot go on to the next section. And if you have just only one section, the participant will not be able to submit the form unless he or she has provided an answer to the question that you have made mandatory. And once you've done that, it will even asterisk it and tells the respondent that that particular question is mandatory before you can move on. This is just by the way, a way of looking at the few things that Google Form can be able to do. At this point, we want to see if we move on to the hands-on experience to see what it entails. We may want to pause for